Well, good morning, ladies and gentlemen. This is David Jalik, joined with Orville Schmidt here this morning in St. Hyacinth. We're just waiting for the second day of our national Holstein show to get started. The Cavs are starting to gather in the holding ring. And we had a great day yesterday, eh, Orville? Maybe give the folks a bit of a rundown.
Well, you got to warn me ahead of time because I got to find my paperwork. But we had some junior champions determined in the black and white show, which came from one of them, I believe, came from the Wainwright herd, and one of them came from Petitclair. Petitclair having first and third junior breeders herd, so they had a good run at it yesterday. And then in our red and white milking show, we had a two-year-old. She became the senior two-year-old. She became the milking champion, the unstoppable daughter from an Armani cow that came out of Eastern Ontario. That was a very nice young cow. And I believe she was followed. I'm not exactly sure who was reserve in the red show, but it was a great day. They showed probably, well, 50 red cows and probably well around 200 heifers. So it was a good start, 200 black and white heifers. It was a good start for the day, and we're ready to get after it here using the same kind of program. This morning we're starting with the red and white heifer show, and when we will determine our junior champion in that, shortly after that we'll be starting with the black and white milkers. And just coming through the barn this morning, it's going to be a fine, fine show. We've got many previous winners at major shows out there that are getting ready, and I think it's going to be a typical Royal Winter Fair. It's going to be a great show. Time we're all done, and grab the coffee pot. I know it's pretty early if those of you in Western Canada, but it'll be another. We'll be at her here for probably a good 6 hours today, so enjoy the day. We'll try to keep you reasonably entertained and informed and go from there.
Well,
we got the same judges today as we had yesterday. Nobody was fired last night.
Well, thank you, Orville. As far as I know, yes, Mike Farlinger will be judging the red and white heifers that are just getting ready to come into the ring. Mike and his wife Tia own Signature Holsteins at Morrisburg, Ontario. Master breeder herd. They milk about 55 cows. And Mike has worked as a fitter all over Canada many years ago. We noted that yesterday. And some real connections to the West. And an interesting side note, they also raise German Shepherd dogs.
So did you buy one of them already, David? Or you got a new puppy going home with you, or are you going to wait for a year?
No, but I noticed the policeman that grabbed you last night had a German Shepherd beside him.
He needed a bigger dog. He needed a bigger dog. That's right. Hey, it's. I got away with it because I couldn't speak the language, so we're okay for last night. Maybe don't want to try it again today. No, that's good, David. That's actually, he did mention a point. That was one of the reasons, if you're wondering why our schedule is a little different this year is for that reason. We showed the Red Milkers yesterday morning so that if anyone wanted to show the Red Cows in the Black and White show, they had a chance to get them re-uttered and get them ready to go. And I know there's going to be one for sure, and there may be one or two more than that before the day's all over. I know the exhibitors have indicated they were going to try to get a few of them they wanted to bring back out today. So it just depends how they got ready, and we'll see how that all develops. I know we did have a few red and white calves came out in the Black and White Heifer Show yesterday, so that's easy to do with young stock. So they're... The Reds are going now, and we'll be showing, I think we're scheduled to start showing Black and White Milkers about 3.5 hours. I think it's 11 o'clock Eastern time that we're scheduled for the Milkers. So I see they're getting going in the hitching ring. I think if you're on track here, the screen should come to life here very shortly, and we'll be ready to go.
And I've got a couple of things to note. My good friend Russell Gammon, who joined you and I, Orville, in Red Deer to do this very same thing for a short bit, keeps coaching me. Unlike many people, he says, "David, I can't hear you." Some people said, "David, you talk too much." So, Russell, this is a sound check. Can you hear me? And when I get a text acknowledging that, I will carry on, though, and thank the Willem and Joanne Vanderlinde family. Willem's watching there from Lacombe in his beautiful office. He sent me a picture of all his winning ribbons. And they sponsored this live stream, so we're very grateful for that. Lucky Hill Holsteins.
And Willem being also being a national director on Holstein Canada, he had some family issues this year that they didn't allow him to travel, and he wasn't able to be here in person, but he indicated his support by sponsoring the live stream for the rest of you out there. So if you know Willem or you see him or at any time, acknowledge the fact that you were aware that he was part of this broadcast as well.
Well, he's got several children, some of them involved in the farm. One's... An entrepreneur.
One's involved in hockey.
Yeah, there's a hockey player, and
he's got many, many irons in the fire, Willem, and that was one of the things. And as you all know, if travel isn't as easy and as uncomplex as it used to be, so I think sometimes people have just can't seem to get away because they're not sure of how things are going to work. So, looking forward to getting back to normal and. We'll see how that goes.
Now, additionally here, one of our sponsors, Zoetis, is having a seminar that can be attended by Zoom. There's 50 invited attendees with Holstein Canada that will be held here on the showgrounds discussing genomics. How genomics can be incorporated into your breeding programs and the importance of testing. So we're very grateful to Zoetis for sponsoring that initiative, and they're teaming up with Holstein Canada and initiating a new program that'll be announced today.
Well, very good. Very good to hear. So on our screen here, we're starting to see the calves coming in. I hope everyone at home is seeing the same broadcast. We're starting out with our summer calves, so that's our baby calves that are born in after the 1st of June. And we're going to have supposedly around 8 or 9 entries. We'll try to keep you updated on that information. Who the sires are of some of these winning calves and a little bit of history on them if we know any of it. And we'll try to keep you as informed with some added information today as we go along. If you don't hear us for a while, well, it's not that we fell off the chair or anything. It's just that we're taking a break. But we'll try to do the best we can.
Yeah, additionally, for those of you who didn't tune in, we've got about 100 reds at the show and 400 black and whites. So a round total of 500, that's pretty impressive. Our viewing area is perched a little bit above the ring, so we get a different view than you folks do, but there are, I think, 4, 5, 6 cameras around this beautiful ring to bring you as close to being here as we possibly can. Look forward to any of your comments. And
as I said yesterday, if they're negative, send them to David. If they're positive, send them to me.
I will say that congratulations has to go out to Holstein Canada for facilitating this show. Only having 90 days, Orville, to move this from the Royal and all the infrastructure there to find a location, set up a committee to, there's a heck of a lot of work, and we thank the sponsors as well.
Yes, it's a totally, when you do it in the same place under the same procedure for 50 years and then to move the venue and make sure that you haven't forgot anything that you took for granted over those 50 years is quite an undertaking. And we have to commend the show committee. And David, you happen to be on that, so that's like patting you on your own back, isn't it? Isn't that kind of how that works?
Well, there's a lot of people giving me a lot of accolades, just put it that way, Orville.
And our red show, as well as our black show, they have cattle from all across Canada, the U.S. I'll mention, I just got a great text. David's gone. I can say this. It says, great to hear you again, Orville. Maybe a little too much, Dr. Dave. So I just will pass that on to the public before I actually break David's heart. So.
Also, just a note, if you're looking for the program to follow along, we'll, as often as we can, identify numbers and the sires and the owners. Orville's in charge of that. He's a little slow on the uptake this morning. But we would encourage you to go to Holstein Canada's homepage or on the Facebook page, and I believe there's a PDF or some format where you can download the show program and do your reference checking on entry numbers.
Yeah, that would help you follow along. I know we are, as David said, quite a ways from the ring. As David's a lot older than I am, we have trouble. He has trouble seeing the numbers, and so it's it makes it a little more of a challenge. So we'll try to, if there's something on the screen that we want you to note about a particular animal, just so that you can tie the two together, we'll pass that along. On the screen there now, we have a Diamondback heifer from Fleury, Vernon, and Myrick Holsteins. She's just going by the screen at this point in time. And they do have a great set of cameras here, so we're not always exactly sure where the view is coming from.
Additionally, yesterday the Andrea Crow Award was announced and given out to a great young lady, Lison Cote. She is the daughter of Jocelyn and Maurice Cote. Many of you would certainly know Jocelyn. Quite a cattle dealer, a guy with a great eye and a great sense of humor.
Yeah, no, that's, again, one of those well-bred families that it didn't it didn't come by accident. She's probably the third generation of passion for the Holstein breed, so it doesn't come by accident. Exactly, David. Our judge Mike Farlinger giving them the rundown there this morning. And got some pretty high-profile leadsmen out there early this morning. They must have behaved last night. They're all ready to go today. It's going to be a long day. You'll see many of them out there several times through the day. And as all of these herds or a large portion of these people exhibiting reds, also will have some black cows coming out today.
And there's Murray Reisner in the foreground. He's our very capable ringman, always has been the steward of the ring at the Royal. Very well respected. He keeps the cattle flowing and works in unison with our judge. In behind, that's Mr. Farlinger. They've both got similar haircuts.
Yeah, it's me. I don't know what happened. The wind must have blew pretty strong out here in Eastern Ontario. Blew that away. They're not as well endowed at their top of their head like I am, so that's pretty, I feel sorry for them. In Alberta, you'd have to wear a toque. Your head get pretty cool. But yeah, he's got a class 11 heifers out there today. Looks like he's giving them a good rundown.
Now, we've got a couple of other folks that are going to join us in the program, but they don't get off to an early start. Bill Ron from Farnier Farms and Genosource in the U.S.
He's the youngest member of this crew, so he thought he should stay up a little later, so we haven't seen him yet. So if he's going to function or not, we'll let you know.
Yeah, he may have had a cocktail or two.
Beautiful, beautiful day in Quebec. The sun's coming out. Looks like it's going to be a nice, clear day. It'll be like yesterday afternoon when the sun gets on the other side of the building. We'll get some sunlight right directly into the ring. That really, really tunes it up.
Thank you.
All right, he's making his first pulls. His first pull at this point in time is an unstoppable from Forestell and Trentford, followed by a warrior from Fermalic and Ponderosa. We mentioned them yesterday. So we got our first roll being made there, and we'll try to identify. We started out with an unstoppable. We come by with a Diamondback is in second, and another warrior in third. Fourth is a Diamondback as well. So you've got a couple of great notable sires. Warrior, Unstoppable, Diamondback represented in the first four. All right,
Joel
Phoenix leading.
That's just pulling out there. His calf's not cooperating. Wait till I see Joel. I'll say star leadsman. Brian Karskaden in front of the judge there.
Little bit of a shake. Pulled out his third heifer to lead off the group at this point in time. So as they say, it's never over till it's over. See how they look lined up that way, and
Mary Ev, lot number 10, or entry number 10, is patiently waiting to see where she fits into this mix. And there we have Holstein director Nancy Beerwert in beside Brian Karskaden, just straightening her calf out there.
All right, our second pull has moved the warrior calf from Malik and Ponderosa has moved into the number one spot. And
just on that, Ponderosa is actually Agostino from Spain, and he's got a 50-50 partnership with Malik. And he's actually bought a property here in Canada.
Okay.
Maybe moving to Canada.
He's
good for the Holstein business.
He had his name out a few times yesterday, so that's great to see. And I know he's another fellow that would love to be here. And when he has come to the Royal, has left his mark. So good to talk. Hope you're listening, and hope things are good.
Well, just to correct you, he is here.
Oh, he is. Okay.
And he did share a couple of glasses of wine with me last night. So Orville,
or you shared with him? Is that how did that really work?
No, he's the one that can afford the wine. I can assure you of that.
Oh, that's great. I'm glad there was. And I did see some of our Italian friends in the barn yesterday. They'd be here to support the associate judge, and so it's great to see some foreigners have made their way back to Canada. That's a wonderful Wonderful sign that we're getting back to normal. We had a great mentioning that. We had those of you that didn't check in yesterday. We had a great farm auction sale here in Quebec on Wednesday, the Jacob sale. Great number of people out to be at a sale like it used to be. It was a great experience and a great reconciliation of friends and neighbors. It was a wonderful afternoon at St. Jacob's. And the sale went along pretty good, too, averaging over $10,000 on 170 head. Some of those cows will be exhibited later on today in the Black and White Show, so we'll try to keep you informed if there was any connection to the sale. So the judge has made his final placings, and we're starting off with a Warrior Calf from Malik and Ponderosa, followed by an Unstoppable from Forestell and Trentward. Then another Diamondback from Fleury, Marianne, and Merrick Holsteins. And another Diamondback from Carnview Farms, followed by a Altitude from Cherry Crest. Those are your top five.
At this time, I would ask...
Oh, pardon me, the Cherry Crest was fourth.
In a row, please. Je demandais à les jeunes éleveurs de faire un pas vers l'avant de la rangée, s'il vous plaît. Winners in the summer calf class, gagnant de la classe de jeunesse d'été, first and best bred known number four. Première ainsi que meilleure propriété élevée, le numéro 4, Malik Pond Daisy, owned by propriété de ferme Malik and Ponderosa Holsteins. Second, number 6, deuxième numéro 6, Trentward Unstoppable Rose, owned by propriété de Matthew Forestall and Trentward Farms. Third, number 10, troisième numéro 10, Fleury, Merrick D.B. Verona, owned by propriété de Fleury Holsteins, Martin Verona and Merrick Holstein.
Take it as a compliment when they get to jaw and calling me a redneck man. I ain't happy if the day's not spinning. I holler fire water bottle in my hand. I leave it in the dust if it can't get muddy. I kiss that girl if she jam a little country.
So here we are coming down the lineup. Our first class of red and white heifers today, ladies and gentlemen. If you're just clocking in, this is our summer calf class, the June babies. And headed off by Malik Pondy Daisy, a warrior from a Solomon.
Great young leadsman here today.
I know you said young because you're not out there, but yeah, their crew is a little younger than you are. There's no question about that. Getting ready with our next class. They're already entering the ring. You'll see them on the backside there coming in. So yeah, don't get confused. That's the next class. And what you're seeing on your screen now is the lineup of the top six from the summer calf class. So we'll get our reasons.
Just a comment or two. Thank you, guys. Joel Phoenix there, the leads person, his wife.
Really nice class of summer heifer calves to kick off the heifer portion of our red show here today. Starting the class with a heifer on top, a heifer that uses her overall extremeness, her height, her length. A little nicer at the point of her shoulder, a little tighter at the point of her shoulder, a slight advantage, a little longer through her neck region than our beautifully balanced heifer we have in second. Heifer in second, I just love the balance of this heifer. A heifer that the nice openness to her rib, hardness to her top. I really admire the way the way this heifer moves about the ring. She really travels freely on her rear legs. And it's for these reasons that take her over our third place heifer. Just that freedom of movement and that flex of hawk when she moves. Our third place heifer is just a little more heifer up through her front end region. A little wider of her chest, a little deeper of her fore rib than this stylish heifer we have in fourth. Our fourth place heifer is just a little more heifer than our fifth place heifer. Taller at the point of her shoulder. Just get the blending of, I thought lost that for a minute. Just a blending up through that shoulder region than this really pretty, pretty heifer we have in fifth. Fifth place heifer again just moves a little nicer about the ring and just holds herself together a little nicer at all times than our sixth place heifer. Thank you.
Les raisons du juge Farlinger pour l'Atlas de génisse été dans les rouges et blancs. Débute l'Atlas avec la génisse qui est la plus extrême aujourd'hui, une génisse qui l'emporte sur salon pour sa longueur en général. Une génisse qui démontre un petit peu plus de longueur au niveau de son cou et un petit peu plus d'hauteur à la pointe de son épaule que la belle génisse très bien balancée qui se présente en deuxième place. La génisse en deuxième l'emporte sur la génisse en troisième, une génisse qui démontre plus de solidité dans sa dorsale, plus d'ouverture au niveau de ses côtes et qui se déplace mieux sur ses membres arrière que la génisse très large qui se présente en troisième position. La génisse en troisième l'emporte sur la génisse en quatrième pour la largeur à la base de sa poitrine, l'ouverture au niveau de ses côtes avant, l'explosion au passage des sangles et la largeur dans son ensemble par rapport à la génisse très grande qui se présente en quatrième place. Cette génisse en quatrième l'emporte sur la génisse en cinquième. Elle démontre plus de longueur dans son ensemble, une génisse qui est un petit peu plus imposante que la génisse qui se présente en cinquième place. Et la génisse en cinquième l'emporte sur la génisse en sixième. C'est une génisse qui se déplace mieux dans le ring aujourd'hui que la génisse blanche en sixième place.
The results of the summer calf class following your catalogues. Le résultat de la classe de jeunesse d'été en suivant dans vos catalogues. Entry number 1 is 9, numéro 1, 9e. Number 2 is 4, 2, 4e. 3 is 7, 3, 7e. Number 1 is 1st. Milwaukee Premier and is now owned by et maintenant la propriété de Allerway Holsteins and Riverdown Holsteins. Number 5 is 10, middle 5, 6e. Number 6 is 2nd and now best bred and owned. Number 6 est 2e et maintenant meilleure propriété et élevée. Number 7 is 5, 7 est 5e. 8 is 8, 8 est 8e. 9 is 11, 9 11e. 10 is 3rd, 10 3e. And number 11 is 6, le numéro 11, 6e. 11 ahead were shown in the class, 11 tight fit exposé dans la classe.
Into our ring, into your viewing screen, our first junior calf, that being an unstoppable from Malik and Ponderosa again. Young leadsman there out showing his stuff in the ring at the Royal Winter Fair National Show in St. Hyacinth. It sounds a little confusing, but it'll all make sense as we're all done. Now coming into the screen is a red eye from Pole Star and Star Rise. Oh, Oh, we got an empty spot there. Here we go. Another young lady with a red eye calf.
Got to see that sire is a Vogue sire pulled. Haven't heard or seen much of Dave Eastman, but Vogue, that's the partnership with O'Connors and Dave Eastman. Leaders in the pulled business. And Patty Jones, we had her on yesterday, the famous photographer, and the Miranda cow that was bred by Albert Cormier. We just won a big award with Holstein International.
Our judge now assessing a warrior calf from Adam Clark in Clark Valley. Here we have a Jolie Bois altitude daughter from firm Rolandale. One of his great contender cow. Mary Ev with a altitude from Gerald Hallback and Lookout Holsteins. Judge Farlinger now assessing a warrior calf that came all the way from Alberta, made the trip out west, out east, from the Kozak herd in northern Alberta there, great red breeders in central Alberta. So this calf's been traveled a long way in the last couple of weeks. Caitlin Kozak at the halter, a warrior out of her Red Army.
I think the Kozaks, how far do they live from you, Orville? They're up around Edmonton.
Stone's throw away, 10 miles away. So, yes, great neighbors. Been breeding cattle for three generations there as well. Now assessing an unstoppable from Malik and Ponderosa. I believe this is the same mating. These are full siblings, 18 and 19. A Rubel's daughter.
Really Well, good morning, ladies and gentlemen. My name is David Chalik, and I'm pleased to be working with Holstein Canada and Orville Schmidt here on my right, a former president of Holstein Canada. We're doing some of the color commentary on the live stream, which was sponsored by our Alberta director, Willem and Joanne Vanderlinde. Right now, I have the pleasure of introducing Holstein Canada's general manager, or CEO. I'm not sure of the terminology. Relatively new to the role, but doing a fantastic job, and a gentleman I worked with in the past at Alta Genetics. Vincent, please welcome our viewership here early this morning, and say a few words, please.
So, thank you, David. Good morning, everybody. It's our pleasure to offer you this live stream coverage today. I think with the pandemic, we have learned that it's important to connect with everybody, if they are in person or virtually, so that we are really happy to offer you such a great coverage and with a quality image and also great commentator.
Well, thank you, Vincent Landry. Vincent, this was quite a shock for you with COVID, originally living in Quebec. Tell us about your move and getting acclimatized and also some of the challenges faced by Holstein Canada with COVID.
Well, David, as you know, moving, it's one little detail, but when you move during the pandemic, it's a little harder, but it was for me just another adaptation. But I think our team suffered more than me about the situation. We have classifier. We have been able to to be recognized as essential service. So our classifier have been able to go back on the field 2 months after the lockdown. And we have been able to deliver the service coast to coast, except on some area where it was more difficult to go because of the bubble and the regulation. But I mean, so far this team have made a tremendous job during the pandemic, and I want to recognize their work. And yes, it creates some delay sometime and creates some challenge, but so far we have been able to deliver the service coast to coast since last July, so it's a good news.
Well, that's the good news. Of course, there's sad news with the significant portion of your membership and our colleagues. We've got to be thinking about those in the lower Fraser Valley of British Columbia, faced with the challenges of this incredible flood and the disruption and destruction, actually, of their ways of life, their facilities, their animals. Give us some of your thoughts and what you've heard, Vincent.
Yes, it's terrible. I mean, I was there 2 months ago visiting farm in BC, and they already suffer about the fire too few months ago. So all the West suffer about the drought, the fire, and now the floods. It's terrible. And the board is committed already with two different measures to support the West. So we suspend the late fees for every animal over the age of 3 months for the next 6 months. So if they have any issue to keep up with the work or the paperwork, we want to support them because they will have a lot of things to take care of more than paper stuff.
Well, thank you, and all of our thoughts are with those struggling in British Columbia and elsewhere, for that matter. Vincent Landry, keep up the great work. Congratulations on putting this show on. It's a huge, unqualified success, no doubt.
Thank you, David, and all the merit go to the organization committee.
Merci beaucoup.
And David, you happen to be on that committee, so you like getting your own back patted every once in a while. It just keeps on and on.
Hey, Vincent, you didn't mention who's on that lovely committee and just how committed they were and the high pay that they got, for God's sake. I'm joking with you. Okay, bye-bye.
All right, here we go with our first poll. Number 14, a warrior coming up the row, followed by number 22, an unstoppable. Unstoppable from Riverdown. And then I believe another unstoppable from Adam Clark in Clark Valley.
At this point, ladies and gentlemen, I'd like to introduce your judge of today's Red and White Holstein show, Mike Farlinger.
Couple of heifers from Quebec, and then our Western heifer coming in the line. So, great day for her.
Operates Signature Holsteins in Morrisburg, Ontario. Signature Holsteins is a master breeder herd where they milk 55 cows in a 2-stall facility and crop 400 acres. Mike has a passion for cows and heifers that excel in type, and you will often find his family exhibiting at local, regional, and national shows around North America. Signature Holsteins has bred or owned over 30 nominated All-Ontario, All-Canadian, and All-American awards. A highlight of Signature's showing career has been breeding two junior champions at the Canadian TD 4-H Dairy Classic Show since 2001. Mike is also a reputable breeder of registered working line German Shepherd dogs that they export over the different countries. In his spare time, Mike thoroughly enjoys helping the next generation of young people that are interested in showing and caring for cattle, which is why he has dedicated 15 years to being a 4-H leader. Mike has judged many shows across Canada, including the Ontario Summer Show, Perth-Waterloo County, Ontario County, Frontenac County, Quint Championship Show, Prince Edward County, Grenville County, Stormont County, Brome County Show in Quebec, and a county show in Vancouver Island. Mike has judged the Expo Rafaela in Argentina in 2018. Assisting Mike today, we have in Ringman, we have Murray Reisner and Bruno Jumainville. Alors, votre juge aujourd'hui, Mike Fallinger. Mike et son épouse, Sia, possèdent et exploitent Signature Holsteins à Morrisburg, en Ontario. Signature Holsteins est un troupeau de maîtres éleveurs où ils traitent 55 vaches dans une installation à stall entravée et cultivent 400 acres de terre. Mike a une passion pour les vaches et les jeunesses qui excellent dans leur conformation et vous trouverez souvent sa famille en train de participer à des expositions locales, régionales et nationales en Amérique du Nord. Signature Holsteins a élevé ou possédé plus de 30 animaux nominés pour des prix All-Ontario, All-Canadian et All-American. L'un des faits saillants de la carrière de Signature Holsteins a été l'élevage de deux champions juniors au Canadian TD 4-H Dairy Classic Show depuis 2001. Mike est également un éleveur réputé de berger allemand de travail enregistré qu'il exporte dans plusieurs pays. Dans ses temps libres, Mike aime beaucoup aider la prochaine génération de jeunes qui s'intéressent à l'exposition et à l'élevage de bovins. C'est pourquoi il a consacré 15 ans à être un leader des jeunes éleveurs. Mike a jugé de nombreuses expositions à travers le Canada, notamment l'Ontario Summer Show, les comtés de Perth-Waterloo, d'Ontario, comté de Frontenac, Quint Championship Show, comté de Prince Edward, Grenville, Stormont, et l'exposition de Brome ici au Québec, ainsi qu'une exposition de comté sur l'île de Vancouver. Mike a jugé l'Expo Rafaela en Argentine en 2018. Et assistant Mike aujourd'hui, nous avons les maîtres de piste Murray Reisner et Bruno Jumainville. Please give a warm welcome to your judge, Mike Farlinger, along with your ringman. Bonne ben applaudissement pour votre juge, Mike Farlinger, ainsi que Murray Reisner et Bruno Jumainville.
All right, there's your, I think, your final lineup coming around the corner. There we got the Warrior Calf from Adam Clark in Clark Valley heading the line, followed by an Unstoppable from Riverdown Holsteins, and then followed by another Unstoppable from Adam Clark, so he's coming in at first and third in this class. Fourth is an added entry. I can't tell you exactly who it is right now. It's number 515. Fifth is another Unstoppable from Malik and Ponderosa. And then coming in sixth is the heifer from Western Canada, from the Cossacks, a warrior from a Red Army. Great day for Caitlin and her crew. Nice, nice class of calves. There's a great front end view of your junior calf class. Great growthy heifers, just born in March, only 7 or 8 months old. What a great bunch of calves. See Judge Farlinger in the background,
again,
finalizing his reasons.
Forward in the row, please. Je demande à tous les jeunes éleveurs de faire un pas vers l'avant, s'il vous plaît. Winners in the junior calf class, gagnant de la classe de jeunes juniors. First, number 14, première numéro 14, Holzer Warrior Princess, owned by propriété de Adam Clark and Clark Valley Holsteins. Second and best bred and owned, number 22, deuxième ainsi que meilleure propriété élevée, numéro 22, Riverdown Unstoppable Escamper, owned by propriété de Riverdown Holsteins. And third, number 23, troisième de numéro 23, Darcroft JC Unstop, Alabama, owned by propriété de Adam Clark and Clark Valley Holsteins.
You know, Orville, we've had comments come in from Europe and Hawaii. You talk about the time difference between those areas. Certainly, people are at different times of the day when they're tuning in to us here, from early, early morning to later in the evening. But we welcome everyone here to our national show in St. Hyacinth's. We've had tremendous participation by sponsors and by exhibitors, very eager to participate, get together, and promote the Holstein breed.
No, I think that's exactly right, David. And to have people, we all know we can't all get here in person. And anything that you're hearing or seeing and you would like to see change for down the road, I mean, I think these live streams are becoming a way of the future. Don't be afraid to, David keeps mentioning about the committee, but they would love to hear the feedback so that we can keep it up updated and interesting for down the road. I mean, I think this may be the way of the future in a lot of these national events, just to, because some people don't like to travel as much anymore, and you can't get a huge crowd at ringside. I think these are ways to kind of get around some of the hurdles, but also do as much promotion for our breeders and exhibitors as we possibly can.
A really nice class of junior calves here this morning, and a close fit at the top of the class here for me today. In the end, just giving this heifer on top, just love her femininity, her balance, her style. Just maybe give her a slight advantage in the flatness of her bone, the way she keeps her rear legs under her at all times, maybe just a touch nicer than our second place heifer. Our second place heifer, we just love her openness, her development, her spring and her sweep of her rib. And it's that correctness through her mid region. And maybe just a touch nicer in her pin set to carry her over this beautiful balanced heifer we have in third. Third place heifer just maybe tracks out a little straighter on her legs, on her rear legs. Just maybe doesn't hawk in quite as much as our, again, another really well-balanced feminine dairy heifer in fourth. Our fourth place heifer fits the pattern of the three above her. Just uses that femininity, cleanness up through her neck and down through her thigh to go over this big, powerful heifer we have in fifth. The fifth heifer, in turn, uses that power and overall scale and development to go over our sixth place heifer. Thank you.
Les raisons du juge Fartinger pour la classe de génisse junior. Un placement serré pour débuter la classe entre deux très belles génisses. Donne un léger avantage à la génisse en première position pour sa féminité, son style. Génisse qui détient une qualité de sature, un os un petit peu plus plat, surtout au niveau du jarret. Donne un certain avantage aussi au niveau de la position de ses membres arrière par rapport à la génisse très ouverte qui se présente en deuxième place. La génisse en deuxième l'emporte sur la génisse en troisième, par son ouverture de côte, par l'arc de ses côtes, et aussi un léger avantage au niveau de la position de ses ischions. La génisse en troisième l'emporte sur la génisse en quatrième. C'est une génisse qui se déplace mieux aujourd'hui. Une génisse qui démontre une meilleure vue des membres arrière, en plus de démontrer plus de masse et de longueur et de largeur que la génisse qui se présente en quatrième place. La génisse en quatrième, c'est une génisse qui est très similaire à la génisse qui est devant elle, une génisse qui est extrêmement féminine et laitière. Et la génisse en cinquième l'emporte sur la génisse en sixième. C'est une génisse qui démontre plus de développement et plus de masse que la belle génisse en sixième place.
The results of the junior calf class falling in your catalogues. Les résultats de la classe de jeunesse junior en suivant dans vos catalogues. Entry number 12 is 7, 12, 7e, 13 is 14, 13, 14e. 14 is first, 14, première. 15 is 10, 15, dixième. 16 is 9, 16, neuvième. 17 is 6, 17, sixième. 18 is 5, 18, cinquième. 19 is 12, 19, douzième. Number 20 is 11, 20, onzième. 21 is 13, 21, treizième. 22 is second and best bred known, 22, deuxième, ainsi que meilleure propriété élevée. 23 is 3, 23, 3e. 24 is 8, 24, 8e. And we have one added entry, number 515, which is 4th. Nous avons une entrée additionnelle, numéro 515, qui est 4e. Blondin Luxor Twinkle Red, owned by propriété of Brian Joseph Enright.
Well, through the day, we're going to interview some very influential and notable and interesting people, as well as very attractive, I must say. So is that inappropriate? Erica, I have Erica Enright from the famous herd of Winright Holsteins, who had a big day today, and you're showing today and has taken the time to come up and visit with us. Erica, you're on international live stream here, so I'm glad you brushed your teeth and have a beautiful smile. Tell us how things are going in the barn for Winright.
Good morning, Dave. That's quite the introduction. Wow. I'm happy to be up here this morning to come see you. Yeah, things are great. It's busy, lots of hustle and bustle. People are in good spirits. I think the show's been really well received. People are so happy to be here. We're very happy to be here. We had a great day yesterday and a couple little red calves this morning, and looking forward to the black calves this afternoon.
Well, and we certainly were able to note just how often the Winright and your heifers were placing yesterday. And give us some of your notable placings. I know in an incredibly competitive environment, you had the second breeder's herd for bred and owned junior females. Give us some more of the highlights, please.
Yeah, that was really great. Reserve junior breeder, I think, is something really special to us. We've been very lucky to have a few sales over the last year or two, and to see some of those animals come back and do well for other people is always really, really rewarding. Yesterday, I would say for me, my highlight would be our second place fall calf, Sidekick Arsenic, from our good friends at Petit Claire. We've had a lot of fun with her this year. She got out great yesterday. We were really, really happy. We had three baby Junes that were all in the top 10. That's cool to take those young calves and develop them and see them come out the way you expected. But yeah, it was a really, really nice day. We're happy, very happy. Good to be here.
So for those of you that don't know, Erica is also on the organizing committee and has worked very hard to get this show to the stage that we can now enjoy it. Erica, tell us about your and Tom's operation and I'm sorry, Matt. I keep, there's Tom Enright, there's Matt Enright. Matt, I'm sorry, forgive me. Well, you know, you get nervous on the mic when you're surrounded by all these lovely ladies. So tell us about your and Matt's operation, where you're located. I know you're exporting embryos and buying and selling cattle. Just a bit of a summary, please.
Yeah, thanks, Dave. We do. We milk about 100 cows in a tie stall. We're in Winchester, Ontario. We do that exactly. We've done some business with Dave, actually. But we do have a fair bit of donors that we work with on a regular basis, both cows and heifers. A large part of our business is making show calves and full-aged heifers, as well as flushing for export. We really enjoy working with those donors and different pedigrees and family lines. And it's nice when you can come to a show like this and you hope to have some success and you can turn them into maybe your potential next brood cow or something that you can market internationally through somebody like Dave. Yeah, Matt and I are very hands-on. I do the books. I milk every morning. He does all the feeding and the baby calves. We have a great team at home that we certainly couldn't do what we do without, but we work together day in and day out, and that for me is really special.
Well, and we'll just conclude this as we're pulling calves into the lineup, but you talk about the great people at home, and I know one of your staff, Alex, Julian and Mary Ann's daughter, and it was interesting. I stopped and chatted with her yesterday. I saw her and her mom side by side showing yesterday. So you certainly attract good staff, and you guys have a great reputation. Congratulations on your success. And just give some final comments to the folks that are watching the live stream.
Thanks for taking the time. You're right, Alex is an integral part of our team, and Kyle Henderson as well is at home full time. Thanks for taking the time, Dave. Really appreciate it.
Okay, and say hello to Matt. And of course, if you see Tom, say hi to Tom too. Excuse me, poor Matt. Okay, see you.
Bye. All right, Dave. Class is getting finalized here. We've got our initial row being made, and now coming out in our second row, it's being led off by an analyst from Stan Howe Holsteins, followed by Awesome from Hallback and Lookout coming in second. And third, we've got a moving Lindenwright moving heifer. Hey, one of those new bulls, followed by a Luxor, and then we have another analyst. So five head here in our intermediate calf class, and it's wheeling right along and making his final lineup. Barkley at the halter of the winning calf, the analyst, followed by Callum, as we mentioned yesterday, coming out with the Awesome.
Once again, if there are any 4-H exhibitors, to step forward in the row, please. Il y a des jeunes éleveurs de faire un pas vers l'avant, s'il vous plaît. Winners in the intermediate calf class, gagnant la classe de jeunesse intermédiaire. First, number 27, premier le 27, Millie Analyst Harmony Red, owned by a property de Stan Howe Holsteins. Second, number 29, deuxième le numéro 29, Gary MD WVG Becker Red, owned by a property de Gerald and Kenneth Albach and Lookout Holsteins. And third, number 28, troisième le numéro 28, Oakfield Moving Lila Red, owned by property to Liberty Genetics. Are you whiskey bent and hellbound, even though your mama tried? Did you cruise down a back road with your Dixieland line? Are you on the Chattahoochee on a barefoot blue jean night? Everybody got a small town anthem. Everybody got a story to tell. Everybody got a hallelujah.
A really nice pair of feminine, balanced dairy calves to start this intermediate calf class. Starting with the heifer on top, just giving her an advantage just in her overall development. She's a little deeper through her heart and her chest region, a little more open through her both her rear and her fore rib to go over this stylish heifer we have in second. Second place heifer fits with our winner. She's feminine and balanced and really moves well around the ring. She tracks on her rear feet and legs, and it's just her advantage in mobility carries her over this big, powerful heifer we have in third. Third place heifer, she uses her overall depth. She's a lot more heifer, fuller of her rear flank, a little wider of her chest to go over this tall, long heifer we have in fourth, who in turn uses that length and scale and overall development to carry over our nice dairy we have in fifth. Thank you.
Les raisons du juge Farlinger pour l'Atlas de jeunesse intermédiaire dans le rouge et blanc. Deux jeunesses très féminines qui se présentent dans le début de cette classe. La jeunesse en première place l'emporte sur la jeunesse en deuxième. C'est une jeunesse qui démontre un petit peu plus de profondeur au niveau de ses côtes avant et arrière. Un petit peu plus de développement que la jeunesse très féminine qui se présente en deuxième place. Cette jeunesse très bien balancée, très stylée, l'emporte sur la jeunesse en troisième, surtout au niveau de son déplacement et de la position de ses membres arrière par rapport à la jeunesse très profonde et très puissante qui se présente en troisième. Cette profondeur de côte, la profondeur de son flanc qui donne l'avantage à la jeunesse en troisième par rapport à la jeunesse très grande qui se présente en quatrième. Et la jeunesse en quatrième l'emporte sur la jeunesse en cinquième pour des raisons de longueur et de grandeur que la jeunesse très bien balancée qui se présente en cinquième place.
The results of the intermediate calf class following your catalogs, il est de la classe de jeunesse intermédiaire en suivant vos catalogues. Number 25 is 5, 25, 5e, 26 is 4, 26, 4e, 27 is 1st, 27, première, 28 is 3, 28, 3e, and number 29 is 2, and 29, 2e. Five head were shown in the class, 5 tight for exposure in our class.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, that just completed our intermediate class, heifer class. We're moving on now to our senior class. It'll be a little larger. We've got about 10 head coming in. So have a look at them coming around the ring. And my astute associate, Dr. David, is ready for another one of his roving mic interviews. Take it away, Dave.
Well, thank you, Orville. Yes, we had just interviewed Erica Enright. And now I have the distinct pleasure of interviewing Isabel Jacobs from the famous Jacobs firm, Jacob. Good morning, Isabel, and welcome to the international live streaming of the Holstein Show.
Thank you, and good morning, everybody.
And of course, Isabel has the luxury of being fluently bilingual in both languages, so maybe I'll send her down the street to
David,
interview.
You're barely good in English, so don't try anything in French.
Don't ruin this interview, Orville, for God's sake. Isabel, I'm delighted, given how busy you are. You've had a sale very recently, very successful, and you've got a showstring. Maybe just let everyone know a little bit about how your sale went and how many cattle you're exhibiting here at the show.
We just had a sale that went really good. We're very happy. Average 1040. We had a great time. We're happy people are a fan of our cattle, also like our family, and have lots of trust on many people. And we brought 15 cows at the show and a few heifers. Somewhere went through the sale. And no, they're getting ready pretty good this morning. So we're hoping that we have a good show.
Yes, and of course, there's one cow that stands out in your string.
I'll ask you to stand for the singing of the national anthems by Melissa Marcoux of Holstein Canada. Alors, je vous demanderai, monsieur, madame, mesdames et messieurs, vous levez pour les hymnes nationaux qui vont être interprétés par Melissa Marcoux.
See, can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright
it stalls through the perilous fight. All the ramparts we watched were so gallantly streaming, and the rockets rink loud, the bomb bursting in hell gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say does that star-spangled banner yet wave o'er the land of the free and the home of the brave. Oh, Canada, our home and native land, true patriot love in all of us command. Car ton bras s'est porté l'épée, il s'est porté la croix. Ton histoire est une épopée des plus brillants exploits. God keep our land glorious and free. Oh, Canada, we stand on God. Oh, Canada, we stand on God for thee.
Thank you very much for listening. Merci beaucoup, Michel.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, my apologies. Although the lady singing that anthem I interviewed yesterday, Melissa Marcoux, she's amazing. She's staff member at Holstein
Everyone's
Canada.
Everyone's attention, please. We have three vehicles that are outside parked near the co-op building that need to be moved. Alors, nous avons trois véhicules dehors au côté du pavillon de la co-op qui ont besoin d'être tassés. First one has a Quebec plate, FLK 3473. Le premier est une plaque du Québec, FLK 3473. Second Quebec plate also, L772845. Deuxième d'un camion avec une plaque du Québec, L772845. And the third one is an Ontario plated truck, FV4746. Et le troisième c'est un camion plaqué de l'Ontario avec la plaque FV4746. Veuillez tasser vos véhicules immédiatement, s'il vous plaît. Please move your vehicles immediately.
Well, if Norm Carson would quit interrupting us, we don't really care what vehicles have to be moved. I say tow them, for God's sake.
Careful.
Isabel is here. She wants to get away from me. I thought it was
a reminder for all
for God's sake,
including all barn staff, concerning the wearing of masks. This is a public health rule, not a Holstein Canada rule. Masks must be worn at all times in the arena, even when seated, unless you are eating or drinking. And in the barns, they must be worn at all times unless you're within your own bubble. Alors, encore une fois, la part des masques, s'il vous plaît, c'est un règlement de la santé publique. Et on vous demanderait de porter vos masques à l'intérieur de l'aréna en tout temps, à moins que vous soyez assis après manger ou boire. Et si vous êtes dans les étables, en tout temps, si vous n'êtes pas dans votre bulle locale. Merci.
Okay, forgive me, Isabel. And like you say, maybe one of those vehicles are yours, so you're getting nervous. I'm back to having the pleasure to interview Isabel Jacobs. We got interrupted in our interview. I was about to say you were talking. You've got, I think, 13 or 15 animals in your string, mainly cows. There is one cow that's most prominent and notable to me as I walk behind your string, and that's Shakira. She looks amazing. Of course, she was champion at Madison. Tell us just a few things about Shakira, and I wish you good luck today. Of course, it's the judge's final decision, but she is a truly significant cow. It's noteworthy that Tom Byers is listening to this interview. Good morning, Tom. Many of you in the crowd will know Tom Byers, famous head of Holstein classification. Your cow went 97, which there isn't many of those. Tell us a bit about Shakira and the progeny that you sold in your sale.
We had lots of interest worldwide. Lambda was, she had three Lambda. One that is owned by a guy from New Zealand now. We had one's going in Ontario, and then there's another one staying at our place with the co-owner, people interested in it. Shakira is such a nice, balanced cow. I mean, she do it herself easy. She's easy to look after. She's happy. I mean, I wish her the best today, and it's always, you know, it's, we'll see what happens. I mean, there's lots of good cow today, and, we'll see. It's a judge choice, and but, I mean, she's doing pretty good right now, and we're happy. She's easy cow to look after.
Yes, she certainly looks comfortable in the string. Just a couple of more questions before you go, Isabel. Do you do any judging? Are you judging much?
Before the COVID, I start now. It's a slow down, but that's okay. It'll come. It's not a rush, and I like it. I like good cattle, so. I've always been a fan of good cattle, so it's fun to pick them up in the ring also.
Well, that's great. So, as I say, people are watching internationally. There you have it. Isabel would love to judge anywhere. She's a great lady, and certainly the work ethic and the professionalism and your achievements at Firm Jacobs are well-renowned around the world. Congratulations. I'm delighted on a busy show morning that you come and speak to us. And just give Tom Byers a little message, because he texted me and he said, oh my goodness, I love Isabel. So you better show him some love back.
Good morning, Tom. I don't know where you are, but I'm hoping you're looking at a good show online, and we'll try to keep up a good show until the end for you and everybody's listening. See you, and have a good show, everybody.
Oh, that was wonderful. Great interview, Isabel. Thank you for coming.
Well, David, you hit a jackpot with your guests. I'm not so sure they want to talk to you after you're done, but great interview from a great breeding establishment in this country. But we're seeing our lineup on screen here. Our judge has made his first pull, and heading off the group at this point in time is a heifer that's owned by Pierre Boulet and R&F Livestock, but a heifer they purchased in Alberta a month ago at our red show in at the Westerner. Brought her out here across the country, and she's heading off the class. She's being followed. So we've got a warrior out of a colt, right? Bred by the Kozak family, just one of my neighbors. Followed by a Moran from Firm Fotal and Ray Floor. And coming out in third at this time is a Geordie from Kingsway, owned by London Dairy. So that's our first lineup, our top three. Our fourth one is another heifer from Unstoppable from Adam Clark in Clark Valley. So the same, you know, great bulls are coming through again. But another one of them heifers that made the trip across the country looking to maybe win this class. So let's keep an eye on it. There she goes. There she goes, making her way out. There'll be some excitement in the western ring of the exhibit. Followed by Firm Fortel with a Moran, one of these Morans that's just hitting the heifer row. There'll be probably some fresh Morans next year. One of the most used bulls in the world at this over the last couple of years. Double polled red carrier cow bull out of the great Shower family. Followed by three by these Geordies. We saw the Geordies in the milking show yesterday, and there's Geordies coming out in the show again right now. Yes, I see the leadsman on the winning heifer, Pierre Boulay. He was out in Alberta for our show a month ago and formed a partnership with R&F and purchased this heifer after she was junior champion and brought her here for the next level. So great congratulations to them, gentlemen.
Well, additionally, we had a lot of people from out east that in Red Deer, but Pierre also bought a Jersey cow out there that went on to win the big Jersey show at Lancaster. And if our friend Russell Gammon was here, he probably announced the fact that she became grand champion there. So it's not hard to see that Pierre can find a good one.
No, I mean, and we were lucky enough, just as a side note, the Westerner show at Red Deer, I think, may be the only show in North America that didn't have to cancel at least one time. We got it in last fall, in the fall of 20, kind of between some various difficulties with COVID, but we got it pulled off, and no problems health-wise or any issues last year. And we got her done a month ago again. So I think if it's a message for us working here today, if we follow the rules and do the smart choices, COVID doesn't have to be as scary as it seems to be sometimes. But we need to be vigilant, and we need to be careful, and things can happen. And kudos to agriculture, because agriculture is leading the way in bringing life back to close to normal.
Once again, if there are any 4-H exhibitors to step forward in the row, please. Il y a des jeunes éleveurs faire un pas vers l'avant, s'il vous plaît. Winners in the senior calf class, gagnants dans la classe de jeunes seniors. First, number 37. Premier numéro 37, Kozak Warrior Bombshell Red, owned by propriété de Pierre Boulay and R&F Livestock Incorporated. Second, number 39, also best bred known. Deuxième, ainsi que meilleur propriété élevée numéro 39, Fortal. Ran Loana Red, owned by propriété de Ferme Fortal Austin Incorporé et Ferme Ray Flore Incorporé. And third, number 38, troisième numéro 38, Savagely Unstop Red, owned by propriété de Adam Clark and Clark Valley Holsteins. At this point, for those joining us on the live stream, we will have a video by one of our sponsors, FCC. Alors, pour ceux qui sont en ligne, vous allez avoir un court vidéo de nos commanditaires FCC.
Who is FCC? Well, our About Us is really about you, the goals you want to reach, and the dreams you have. You're invested in your business, and as the only lender 100% invested in Canadian agriculture and food, so are we. Because a dream is just the start. It also needs a lender who understands where your dreams come from, where they can go, and what it takes to get there. If you want to start, grow, or transform your agriculture or food business, we can help. Because we're not just your lender. We're your champion, your catalyst, and we're behind you every step of the way. We are FCC. Dream. Grow. Thrive.
Qui est FAC? Ce que nous sommes est avant tout ce que vous êtes. Les objectifs que vous vous êtes fixés et les rêves que vous souhaitez réaliser. Vous vous investissez à fond dans votre entreprise et nous aussi, car nous sommes le seul prêteur entièrement dédié à l'agriculture et à l'agroalimentaire au Canada. Tout commence par un rêve. Et ce rêve a besoin d'un partenaire qui comprend ce qu'il vous faut pour lui donner vie. Que vous souhaitiez démarrer, agrandir ou transformer une entreprise agricole ou agroalimentaire, nous pouvons vous aider. Plus qu'un simple prêteur, nous sommes un allié, un catalyseur et nous sommes là à chaque étape de votre parcours. C'est ce que nous sommes. FAC, rêver, bâtir, réussir.
A really nice class of senior calves this morning. And as a judge, whenever heifers come out that are extreme in their makeup, yet also fit your pattern of correctness and freedom of mobility, it really makes you smile. And that's these two heifers we have on top. A real nice pair of heifers. And we're going to nitpick a little bit, but we'll give our winning heifer, we're going to get advantage. It's a little longer and cleaner up through her neck, a little more feminine in that region. Maybe just tracks out and keeps her rear legs under and a little straighter. Prefers set to her rear leg a touch over this big, deep heifer we have in second. Second place heifer, a beautiful open-ribbed, hard-topped heifer. She just uses her openness of rib. It's a little more heifer all the way through than this real feminine dairy heifer we have in third. Third place heifer uses that femininity to carry over our fourth place heifer. A little longer and cleaner through her neck. A little flatter of her bone all the way through. Maybe just stands a touch squarer on her legs than our fourth place heifer. Fourth place heifer, she's just more heifer than our fifth place heifer. She's deeper in that rear rib and flank. Just a little more total overall heifer than our fifth place heifer. Fifth place heifer, again, she's just giving her a definite advantage in the way she moves around the ring and just the way she holds those pins down over a big, tall fronted heifer we have in sixth. Thank you.
Les raisons du juge Farlinger pour l'Atlas de jeunesse senior. Très, très impressionné par la qualité des jeunesses qui sont présentées devant lui. Puis il admire vraiment les deux premières jeunesses par leur mobilité, la façon dont ils se déplacent dans le ring. La jeunesse qui l'emporte lui donne un léger avantage au niveau de la longueur et de la féminité, au niveau de sa tête et de son cou. Il donne aussi un léger avantage au niveau de la position de ses membres arrière. Par rapport à la belle jeunesse laitière qui se présente en deuxième place. Celle-ci l'emporte sur la jeunesse en troisième. C'est une jeunesse qui démontre plus de solidité dans sa dorsale, une jeunesse qui est plus massive que la très belle jeunesse qui se présente en troisième place. La jeunesse en troisième l'emporte sur la jeunesse en quatrième. C'est une jeunesse qui démontre plus de féminité aujourd'hui, en plus de mieux se déplacer sur ses membres arrière que la jeunesse très imposante qui se présente en quatrième place. La jeunesse en quatrième l'emporte sur la jeunesse en cinquième. C'est une jeunesse qui démontre plus de profondeur au niveau de ses côtes avant et arrière, plus de taille, plus de grandeur par rapport à la belle jeunesse qui se présente en cinquième place. Et la jeunesse en cinquième par rapport à la jeunesse en sixième, c'est une jeunesse qui se déplace mieux sur ses membres arrière, en plus de démontrer une meilleure position de ses ischions.
The results of the senior calf class following your catalogues. Les résultats de la classe de jeunesse senior en suivant vos catalogues. Number 30 is 11, numéro 30, 11e. 31 is 4, 31, 4e. 32 is 5, 32, 5e. 33 is 9, 33, 9e. 34 is 7, 34, 7e. 35 is 10, 35, 10e. 36 is 8, 36, 8e. 37 is 1st, 37, 1er. 38 is 3, 38, 3e. 39 is second and best bred known. 39, deuxième, ainsi que meilleure propriété et élevée. And number 40 is 6, et le numéro 40 est 6e. 11 head were shown in the class. 11 tight for exposé dans la classe.
Great class of senior calves. Congratulations to the Kozaks and the Western crew and Pierre Boulay on that class winner. Into the summer yearlings. We're going around the ring. Doing some assessments on this class that'll probably have around 7 or 8 entries. Currently looking at assessing a Geordie daughter from Malik and Ponderosa. Heifer that's on your screen right now. These summer yearlings born in from June to August. Just a little over a year old. 42, a heifer that we didn't see. She was another Jordy. She's just on the front of your screen. The back side of your screen is heifer 43. This is another Jordy from Malik and Ponderosa. And then we're looking at a Seamer's Apple Crisp, exhibited by Agri-Bear, Beckeridge, and Quality. Great to see some of our Italian friends here and the guys from Ontario. They've partnershiped on a few heifers yesterday in the Black and White Show, and we'll see them out in the milking show today. Now our judge looking at a heifer from R&F from Western Canada, from Saskatchewan. This is another Unstoppable heifer, exhibited by Barclay Phoenix on the halter. This heifer being another Unstoppable that our judge is analyzing from Raymond Smigwadi and Riverdown Holsteins. Followed by a London Dairy exhibit, a Diamondback from an Avalanche, Sunny Lodge bred cow. And our final entrant in the ring, this is a Cherry Crest exhibit, an Unstoppable daughter, shown by Cherry Crest. Class of 8, summer yearlings. Pretty much the same schedule as yesterday. We're moving right along in our red show. We've got a couple of classes left, and then our groups and our champions. And then we will, whatever time is left before 11 o'clock Eastern Standard Time, when it's scheduled to start the milking classes of our Black and White show. So you should have a few minutes to make a sandwich and a coffee between the two. And hope you enjoy what's coming through so far. My associate, our roving Mike David, is gone, just so that you know. So if you want to text him and mention that he should stay on the job, you can go ahead and do that, because you don't listen to me very well. Leading off the group, lot 44. This is the Apple Crisp, exhibited by Agri-Bear, Beckeridge, and Quality Holsteins. Coming in second, we have the Unstoppable from Andre Dion. And in third, the Weeksdale Jordy Fireball, a Jordy daughter, exhibited by Frank and Diane Borba, High Caliber, Rocky Allen, and Weeksdale. So out with our final lineup. Pretty much the same as he did initially, leading the pack. The Apple Crisp from Agri-Bear, Beckridge and Quality. Followed by the Unstoppable from Andre Dion. The Weeksdale, High Caliber Boar by Exhibit, Rocky Allen coming in third. Smigwati and Riverdown, another Unstoppable in fourth. And then another Unstoppable in fifth. Again, I'm just being sat down by the sire analyst from Blondin, and they happen to be having another good class. It's just funny how stuff works out sometimes. But nice class of heifers that he's putting into the final row, and we're ready to move on. I think our final lineup is done. You're seeing the front end view. Judge Farlinger standing behind, finalizing his reasons. And as they say, it's a done deal. Just told that this heifer was that won the class here today. Was
yearling class, gagnant de la classe d'un ADT. First, number 44, premier numéro 44, Michel Juicy Apple Crisp Red. Owned by Propriété d'Agribert Société Agricole, Beckridge Holsteins, and Quality Holsteins. Second, best bred and owned, number 41. Deuxième, ainsi que meilleure propriété élevée, numéro 41, Clément Unstoppable Redline, propriété owned by André Dion. And third, number 42, troisième, numéro 42, Weeksdale Jordy Fireball Red, owned by propriété de Frank and Diane Borba, High Caliber Holsteins, Rocky Allen, and Weeksdale Holsteins Incorporated.
Truly an international class here. We've got winner being owned by people from Canada and Italy. Our second place heifer being from Quebec. Our third place heifer being owned by someone in the Maritimes and California. Fifth place heifer coming to us from Western Canada. So we've got a truly, truly international class here in front of us. Oh, yes, okay, just been informed that Rocky Allen, co-owner of the third-place heifer, is from Australia, so what a great international class we got going out here today. And we've got some Ontario owners on the first-place and fifth-place heifer, so we've pretty much got her all covered. Congratulations, exhibitors.
too much time being lonely. I could get along with anyone at all, but only a few people really know me. And when it hits the fan, that's who I'm gonna call. 'Cause I got work friends, and I got church friends, I got hometown, grew up on the same red dirt friends. I got great friends, and I got fake friends, I got girls that wanna try, but we can't stay friends. Yeah, all in all, I'd say the life's been good to me so far, but you know where I go when it gets hard, out with my bar friends. Yeah, I'm with my bar friends. You know the ones that show up when it opens, that ain't afraid to stay till closing time, that don't care if you light one up and smoke it, that'll help you drink some trouble off your mind. I got work friends, and I got church friends.
A really nice summer yearling heifer to start this class. A heifer that you admire for her balance and her femininity. She uses that femininity up through her head and neck, and just the way her head blends back into her shoulder, into her chine region, just gives her a little more advantage in style. Slight style advantage over our second place heifer. Also giving her a definite advantage in the set to her rear legs and the cleanness of bone through that hock region over our second place heifer. Second place for a real tall front-ended heifer. Heifer that shows us that uphill run. A heifer with a definite advantage in her openness and her flatness to her rib region. Shows us a little more drop of her rib than does our third place heifer. Third place heifer, a real stylish heifer in her own right. A heifer that just moves about the ring a little freer than our fourth place heifer. Just a little more freedom of movement on her rear legs. Picks them up and puts them down a little nicer than our fourth place heifer. To go over her today. Fourth place heifer in turn, it's a beautiful hard-topped heifer, a heifer that's got her pins set down nice, her thorough's in the right place, and she just uses that correctness through that region to go over our fifth place heifer. Fifth place heifer, she just fits the pattern of the ones above her a little nicer, that overall correctness and completeness to place over our sixth place heifer today. Thank you.
Les raisons du juge Farlinger pour l'Atlas de un an d'été dans les rouges et blanches. Débute l'Atlas avec la génisse qui démontre le plus de féminité, de balancement. Une génisse qui démontre énormément de style. J'ai beaucoup apprécié la façon dont le cou s'agence avec l'épaule. C'est une génisse qui donne aussi un avantage au niveau de la qualité de son ossature, au niveau du jarret spécialement. En plus de se déplacer plus aisément sur ses membres arrière. La génisse en deuxième l'emporte sur la génisse en troisième. Une génisse qui démontre un petit peu plus d'auteur dans son avant-train. Une génisse qui démontre plus d'ouverture et de profondeur de ses côtes que la génisse qui se déplace très bien, qui se présente en troisième place. Cette génisse en troisième l'emporte sur la génisse en quatrième au niveau de la façon dont elle se déplace dans le ring aujourd'hui. Et la génisse en quatrième l'emporte sur la génisse en cinquième. Une génisse qui démontre plus de solidité au niveau de sa dorsale, un rein plus solide. Aussi une génisse qui démontre plus d'angularité en général, en plus de démontrer une meilleure position de ses ischions par rapport à la génisse très correcte qui se présente en cinquième place. Et c'est cet équilibre et ce balancement qui donne l'avantage à la génisse en cinquième par rapport à la génisse en sixième place.
The results of the summer yearling class following your catalog. The résultat de la classe d'un an été en suivant dans vos catalogues. Number 41 is 2, 41 deuxième. Number 42 is 3rd and actually best bred and owned. Numéro 42 est troisième ainsi que meilleure propriété élevée. 43 is 6th, 43 sixième. 44 is 1st, 44 première. 45 is 5, 45 cinquième. 46 is 4, 46 quatrième. 47 is 8, 47 huitième. 48 is 7, 48 septième. 8 head were shown in the class, 8 têtes for exposure dans la classe. Oh, following the red and white show this morning during the break before the black and white classes, cow classes begin. There will be a genomics conference upstairs in the second floor in the restaurant area, and everyone's welcome. Alors, suivant les classes de roue ce matin, il y aura un arrêt de pause avant de commencer avec les noirs à 11h. Et durant ce temps, il y aura une conférence sur la génomique au deuxième étage dans le restaurant, et tout le monde sont bienvenus.
So while we're watching the junior yearlings, this is David Chalik. I get the pleasure of working with a couple of gentlemen here. I don't know if they've introduced themselves. Of course, they were on yesterday. We've got Dan Brady here from Blondin Sires and Firm Blondin. And of course, we've got Bill Rowan from Farnier, Genosource, and all places focused in Iowa. So we've brought people from around the globe, specialists. I'll ask each of you to say good morning and make some introductory comments, and then we may get into a conversation about things that'll be of interest on the breeding side for the viewing audience. Over to you, Dan.
Good morning, everyone. Hope you're enjoying the show at home. This is Dan Brady speaking. Glad we'd be back today again. I know our Snapchat question yesterday went over very well about the some cows that we wish we had seen and never got the chance to, so we can relive that again someday. Everyone seems to have a different answer, but yeah, glad to be back again today and excited. I'm a big Red fan. I love Reds, so I'm excited to watch the show here today.
Good morning, everyone. Bill Rowan, checking back in here at the show. I had an opportunity to walk around this morning through the cow barn, seeing the black and whites getting ready, and we're going to have a nice show here this afternoon all the way through, so it should be one of the best black and white cow shows, I think, in maybe the history of a show in North America.
You know, early in the morning on show day, Bill, everybody's trying to gauge those udder fills, and did they have the timing right? What did you see as you walked around the barn?
I would say overall, most are on point. There's a few probably could be a little short, and there may be a few that are getting some ice out. But overall, I think it's going to be good.
Yeah, actually, one thing about this show, David, is it's a totally different schedule. So we saw yesterday we had the red cows and the black and white heifers. And then today we have the red heifers and the black and white cows. And so far our team's loving it. It's given us some extra time to work. So we're not rushing to do everything all at once. It kind of gives us a little bit of a break. Our team, we've been pretty happy about this schedule. And it finished at a good time last night. It lets us all have a social pop or two and talk to these people we haven't seen for the last 2 years. So it's been going good. I like this new schedule.
And that schedule was tweaked several times as we led up to this, trying to configure it. I think the driving force behind it, Dan, was the fact that those really good red cows that showed yesterday were judged early enough. They could be bagged by in time for today. And maybe you'll comment about the Grand Champion cow that actually had a Blondin prefix. And you could share some of the story of that young cow and her genesis also related to being able to show again today, which I think you said was likely yesterday.
Yeah, that's right, David. Her name's Blondin Unstoppable Maple. However, she has never actually stepped foot at Blondin. She was sold her dam we owned and used some of the first doses of Unstoppable and bred her. And then she ended up, we sold the dam, an Armani cow that showed really well at the Royal. And we sold her to Adam Hodgins and Select, and they calved. Maple was born at their place, and of course went on to calve in really well last year. She showed in the black and white show last year as a milking yearling and won at the show in Lindsay. And then they calved her in here again as a second calf, senior two, and they sold her this summer for a good amount, and sold her to Bill Schilling and Doe Briners. And they took her down to the U.S. and got her ready for Madison, where she won there as well. So, yeah, so this new schedule is, it's great that we can get the reds, the best reds back in with the black and whites. I know we're tied right beside Quality. I saw them this morning. They've got a couple cows uttered up, red cows, to go again here today. So, I think the reds, actually, I was working on a Facebook post about this lately, is I think the reds are right in there now with the blacks. Like, the best of the reds can compete right there with the best of the blacks. And I think the cool part about today is we're going to see it. We're going to get to see how they roll. So, anyway, yeah, it's been going good so far.
Thanks, Bill. You're associated with ST and Genosource. Give us your impressions of where the red thing's going in the States, and do you guys dabble in that at all or not?
Well, yeah, I think, as Dan said, along his comments or whatever, I think the red and whites have improved so much. A lot of that, I think, has to do with Apple and the mammary systems. I think over the last couple of years, the udders on the red and whites probably are the same, if not better. Maybe then the black and whites, a few sires and that have probably helped along the ways. And then also the reds have made a lot of improvements, I would say, in frame, dairy quality in their dairy frame, their style, cleanliness of bone to compete with the black and whites, the gold ones and that, the eunuchs now. So I think the red and whites in the last 5 years have made tremendous strides. And improvements all the way through, starting first obviously with the mammary systems and then their frame style, dairy character all the way through and feet and legs. So it's nice when you can get the red and whites compete with the black and whites and find out who the best of the best is.
Okay, well, they've made their pulls. Dan, maybe make some comments and give us a bit of a play-by-play on as they're coming around here.
No problem. I was just trying to. Orville was actually doing. We ended up doing a lot of talking here, so Orville was doing more watching. Did you you have some comments there, Orville?
I hate deferring to Orville. Like, Orville, did you come back? You were having a little snooze there. Tough night last night.
This is coming from the guy who's been roving around and away from the table, unless he's talking to somebody, and then he leaves you all alone. And then when you go to get a coffee, then you were having a snooze. Okay, let us know how that goes. But we're starting off this bunch. On your screen you see here, we've got a warrior heifer coming in from Malik and Ponderosa, mentioning that combination in the last couple days quite often. Then followed by another Jordy from the Cherry Crest group, exhibited by Pierre Boulay. And then coming out in third, we have, I believe it's exhibit number 50, which is an intense exhibited altitude daughter. And coming in fourth is the Cherry Crest Lee bred Polestar Star Rise exhibit, an awesome daughter. So we got some little different bulls, but we've also got some, since we got the Blondin guy up here, we're gonna give him another shout. We got a Blondin Warrior bull winning from a Lotus, who was a Blondin bull as well. So before he mentions it, I might as well mention it, because he would have done it anyway. So our class is lining up here, and this is our junior yearling. Some big framey heifers coming out here, and we've got one more class coming in, and then we'll be into our groups and our champions. So it's moving along quite nicely.
Well, we've got quite a diverse crowd watching this morning, and I know Wendy Weir from Farmstead Travel, Farmstead Enterprises. She provides a lot of the promotional material for the various clubs throughout Canada. But she's spread her wings, as it were, and likes to fly all over the world. She just got back from Jamaica.
First and best bred known, number 49. Première ainsi que meilleure propriété élevée, numéro 49. Malik Warrior Red Eleganza, owned by Propriété de Fel Malik and Ponderosa Holsteins. Second, number 55, deuxième numéro 55, Cherry Crest Trapezoid, owned by Propriété de Cherry Crest Holsteins. And third, number 50, troisième numéro 50, Intense Altitude Passion, owned by Propriété de Fel Intense Incorporé et Marc La Liberté et Lynn Jutro.
As before I was interrupted, I was talking about Wendy Weir and her Farmstead ventures. This lady's traveling all over the world these days, and she's actually planning an excursion to the European Holstein Show next year in Italy. I know I went to the show in Cremona. It's an incredible event, and I think I'm going to get a commission on every seat that she sells on this tour to Italy, although I'll only go if Orville doesn't go. So Wendy, kind of screen the applicants, would you please?
For those following on the online feed, you will now have a commercial by our main sponsor CIMEX. Alors pour ceux en ligne, vous allez avoir un court vidéo de nos commentaires principaux CIMEX.
You're seeing our final group of six coming in here to be placed in this junior yearling class. And those of you that we're getting,
extreme scale to start this junior yearling class here this morning. Heifer that's very tall, very long, yet very feminine and dairy, and a heifer that carries her pins down nicely, and carries out a hard high loin. She just uses her overall extreme to go over our second place heifer. It's a lot taller, a lot longer, and a little cleaner. Our second place heifer, I just prefer her structure up through her front end. I prefer at the point of her shoulder. I prefer her how she blends back in from that neck to her shoulder through her crop region. And I also give her a definite advantage down through her hock region and the way she keeps her feet and legs underneath her and her cleanness of bone through the hock over this third place heifer. Third place heifer just uses some her femininity. She's cleaner through the neck. It's quite a bit cleaner down through her thighs and through her flank region than this big strong heifer we have in fourth. Fourth place heifer just taller at the point of her shoulder. It's a little more heifer all the way through than this nice heifer in fifth, who shows us a little more openness, a little more sweep to her rib, a little bit more flatness of bone and femininity than this tall heifer we have in sixth. Thank you.
Les raisons en français pour l'Atlas de Nage Junior pour le juge Farlinger. Une jeunesse tout à fait extrême pour débuter l'Atlas. C'est une jeunesse qui démontre plus de grandeur, plus d'ouverture. Une jeunesse qui est une gagnante par ses qualités extrêmes. Une jeunesse qui démontre un rein plus solide aussi que la jeunesse bien équilibrée qui se présente en deuxième place. La jeunesse en deuxième l'emporte sur la jeunesse en troisième. Le juge a préféré la structure de son avant-train, la façon dont son cou s'agence avec l'épaule. Une jeunesse qui démontre aussi plus de netteté au niveau de son jarret aujourd'hui. La jeunesse en troisième l'emporte sur la jeunesse en quatrième. Une jeunesse qui est plus féminine, qui a aussi plus de netteté au niveau de son cou par rapport à la jeunesse grande et forte qui se présente en quatrième place. La jeunesse en quatrième donne un avantage pour sa stature, son ouverture au niveau de ses côtes. Une jeunesse qui est aussi plus féminine que la jeunesse très profonde qui se présente en cinquième place. Et la jeunesse en cinquième l'emporte sur la jeunesse en sixième. C'est une jeunesse qui démontre plus d'ouverture au niveau de la structure de ses côtes, en plus de démontrer plus de profondeur aujourd'hui.
Results of the junior year in class following in your catalogs. It is de la classe de la junior suivant dans vos catalogues. First and best bred and owned, number 49. Première meilleure propriété élevée, numéro 49. Number 50 is 3, 50, troisième. 51 is 7, 51, septième. 52 is 5, 52, cinquième. 53 is 4, 53, quatrième. 54 is 6, 54, sixième. 55 is 2nd, 55, deuxième. Number 56 is 8, et le numéro 56, huitième. 8 head were shown in the class, 8 têtes for exposed in our class. In the red and white show, we had a total of 57 heifers and 41 cows for a grand total of 98 head. Dans l'exposition rouge et blanche, nous avons eu 57 jeunesses d'exposés et 41 vaches pour un total de 98 têtes.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, we don't have any milking, intermediate yearlings. So the individual classes have now been completed. We're going to do our breeders' groups. It looks like we've got a couple of them coming in the ring. And then we'll be heading right into our junior champion. So you'll have time here you'll have about an hour break to either do some chores or make a coffee or a sandwich before we kick into the milking black and whites at 11 o'clock. So that's the schedule here right now. We've completed a little ahead of schedule, and which is kind of cool because it allows us to refocus and get ready to go again. So we'll keep you updated on these groups and then be ready for junior champion.
Again, I'd like to just point out our judge today is Mike Farlinger from Signature Holsteins, located in Morrisburg, Ontario. That's about halfway between St. Hyacinth's here and the city of Toronto on the Ontario side of the border. Mike and Tia, by the way, Tia originates from Alberta. That's where all the good females are generally. Well, I better be careful. I'm married to a lady from BC. Orville, are you still married? He went out of the country. He's got a French-speaking lady.
Well, yes, I had to try to join our country together. I'm doing my best for national unity. So, but she was raised in Alberta as well, so I can't really say it's...
Yeah, the beautiful town of Beaumont,
Alberta. Hey, the mini Quebec City right in the middle of Alberta. There you go.
Okay. On a serious note, Mike and Tia have a herd focusing on type and cow families. Lots of judging. Mike was a fitter out west, and we all got to know him. It's a small industry, as you all know. So it's great to see everybody out, and you'll see Mike in behind this group walking around. He's just coming and moving to the next group there on your screen.
Thank you.
Three groups out there. Looks like we're heading off with the Cherry Crest group. Congratulations to our national director, Nancy Beer Ward Johnson, Donnie Johnson's group, family. What a great touch.
Three really nice groups out here for our junior. Starting the class with this group on top, a real uniform a group of heifers. They're all roughly the same size. And their uniformity and just a little more correctness through their feet and legs take them over the second place heifer, second place group. A real dairy group and a group that uses their extreme scale for age to go over a nice balance group that we have in third. Thank you.
Les raisons du juge Fardinger pour l'Atlas de groupe dans les Rouges et Blancs. Il mentionne que c'est trois très, très beaux groupes de génisses qui lui sont présentés. Le groupe en première place l'emporte pour son uniformité, des génisses qui se ressemblent beaucoup. Donne aussi un léger avantage au niveau de la qualité des pieds et membres par rapport au groupe de génisses très laitières qui se présente en deuxième place. C'est ce caractère laitier et puis le développement et la maturité des génisses en deuxième place qui lui donne l'avantage par rapport au groupe de génisses très bien balancé en troisième place.
The results of the banner class, les résultats de la classe de bannière, de junior banner, junior herd, excuse me, de troupeau junior. First, number 57, premier, numéro 57, Cherry Crest. Deuxième, second, Malik. And third, troisième, Etel. We will just now have the presentation of the banners. So we have the top sires of the junior show. Alors, meilleur taureau du show junior aujourd'hui. En troisième point, third with 29 points, troisième 29 points altitude. We have a tie in second place with 45 points. Ixaku en deuxième place at 45 points, Warrior Red and Jordy Red. And junior sire with 77 points. Premier taureau, 77 points, unstoppable. Overall sire, taureau de la journée au complet. Third with 96 points, troisième à 96 points, Avalanche. Second with 37 points, deuxième 137 points, Jordy Red. And premier sire with 144 points, premier taureau, 144 points, unstoppable. Now for the junior banners, pour les bannières junior. Junior breeder banner, bannière junior d'éleveur. Third with 15 points, troisième 15 points, Kozak. Second with 25 points, deuxième 25 points, Cherry Crest. And junior breeder with 37 points, il a gagné 37 points, préfixe Malik. For the junior exhibitor banner, bannière junior d'exposant, we have a tie in third place with 15 points. Exaco en troisième place at 15 points. André Dion and River Down and Allerway Holsteins. Second with 25 points. Deuxième 25 points. Cherry Crest. And we have a tie for the junior exhibitor banner at 31 points each. Alors, Exaco en première place at 31 points chaque. Malik and Ponderosa and Clark Valley and Adam Clark. For the overall breeder banner of the red and white show, gagnant la bannière d'éleveur de position en Auger Blanc. Third place with 61 points, troisième avec 61 points, Malik. Second with 72 points, deuxième avec 72 points, Etel. And the premier breeder with 95 points, et le gagnant avec 95 points, Rolandel. Overall exhibitor, exposant. Third with 48 points, troisième avec 43 points, Quality Holstein, Beckridge, and Aguibert. Second with 55, deuxième avec 55 points, Malik and Ponderosa. And the exhibitor winner with 88 points, et le gagnant avec 88 points, Rolandel.
Well, guys, I just got off the phone with Tyson Flamin. They're having a live stream watching party at the office of Willem and Joanne Vanderlinde. I know I've mentioned it a few times, but thank you to so much for Lucky Hill. Of course, Tyson is a big mover and shaker for the Red Deer Show, along with my brother and his family and all the directors there. So they're familiar with what it takes. We have a little more stringent rules of content on this stream than we do on that more rustic one out west. So we're keeping it between the ditches, and thankfully Bill Ron is here to stray every now and again. He looks tough this morning. Oh my God.
David, he is still young, and he thinks he's bulletproof, but I think there might be a dent in the armor this morning. David, I can't. We have to admit, we both been there, done that, and bought the T-shirt. So, yeah. Again, congratulations to Malik on their great wins in the banner part of this show, and we're getting ready to bring in our class for our junior champions, our first and second place animals that we've exhibited this morning, and Judge Farlinger gets to finish off his program in fine style with a bunch of great red heifers. And as I said, we'll have probably about a little better, not quite an hour break, so if you got anything you need to do, kind of plan for it. And we'll be right back here at 11 o'clock Eastern Standard Time, broadcasting the milking show. As Dan was saying before, there's going to be some great cows coming out. We're going to have a great afternoon. Congratulations as well to the Blondin team, Blondin Sires, for Unstoppable's win as Premier Sire of the Red Show, and a great feather in their hats. Congratulations.
Just a reminder for everyone following the junior championship this morning, there will be the genomic conference upstairs on the second floor. Everyone's welcome. And we will resume with the black cow classes at 11 o'clock. Alors, juste un rappel que suivant la classe de championnat junior, il y aura une conférence sur la génomique en haut au deuxième étage. Tous sont bienvenus. Et nous résumerons à 11 heures avec les classes de vaches noires et blanches. We will now proceed to our junior championship parade. Alors, la parade championnat junior. We have our winners from the summer calf class, gagnant dans la classe de jeunesse d'été. First was number 104, première le numéro 104, Malik Pond Daisy, owned by propriété de Allerway Holsteins and Riverdown Holsteins. Second, number 6, deuxième le numéro 6, Trentworth Unstoppable Rose, owned by propriété de Matthew Forstel and Trentworth Farms. Our winners from the junior calf class, gagnant de la classe de jeunesse junior. First was number 14, première le numéro 14, Holzer Warrior Princess, owned by propriété de Adam Clark and Clark Valley Holsteins. Second was number 22, deuxième le numéro 22, Riverdown Unstoppable Escamper, owned by propriété de Riverdown Holsteins. From their intermediate calf class, gagnant de la classe de jeunesse intermédiaire. First was number 27, première le numéro 27, Millie Analyst Harmony Red, owned by propriété de Stanhall Holsteins and Keaton Phoenix. Second was number 29, deuxième numéro 29, Gary MD, WBG Becker Red, owned by propriété de Gerald and Kenneth Hallback and Lookout Holsteins. Our winners from the senior calf class, gagnant de la classe de jeunesse senior. First was number 37, première le numéro 37, Kozak Warrior Bombshell Red, owned by propriété de Pierre Boulay and R&F Livestock Incorporated. Second, number 39, deuxième le numéro 39, Fortal Mirin Leona Red, owned by propriété de Ferme Fortal Austin Incorporated et Ferme Riflard Incorporated. Winners from the summer yearling class, gagnant de la classe 1 à d'été. First was number 44, première le numéro 44, Michelet Juicy Apple Crisp Red, owned by propriété de Agabert Société Agricole, Beckridge Holsteins, and Quality Holsteins. Second was number 41, deuxième numéro 41, Clémar Unstoppable Redline, owned by propriété de André Dion. And we have our winners from the junior yearling class, gagnant la classe 1 à junior. First was number 49, première le numéro 49, Malik Warrior Red Eleganza, owned by propriété de Fel Malik and Ponderosa Holsteins. Second was number 55, deuxième le numéro 55, Cherry Crest Trapezoid, owned by proprietor Cherry Crest Holsteins. This time, ladies and gentlemen, show your appreciation for the breeders, the exhibitors, and the judges' work. Une bonne main pour le travail des éleveurs, des exposants et le travail du juge.
Well, there you have the official presentation of our class winners and our potential candidates for our junior championship class, winding up the Red and White Show, which started yesterday with red and white cows, and they're going to finish with the heifers today. Unstoppable doing a fine job, and Blonde and Sire is winning some of the Sire Awards here today, so a great congratulation out to them. And a great bunch of heifers that we got coming in, and a lot of them will be back next year as fresh young cows. So it's going to be fun watching them all develop. Judge Mike Farlinger moving out his final considerations for his junior champion class. Coming out with the summer calf. We've got a couple of senior calves. Couple of junior calves, a junior calf coming out, two senior calves. Summer yearling. Those are our final four, as they would say in the basketball circles, the final four. Exhibit of Adam Clark in Clark Valley is a Warrior calf is the summer calf, is the junior calf. Senior calf is the Kozak Warrior Bombshell heifer, bred in Western Canada, now exhibited by Pierre Boulay and RF Livestock. Followed by her contemporary in that same class, Fortale Moran Luna, owned by Firm Fortale and Firm Ray Floor, as a Moran daughter. And final one in the group being the Apple Crisp from Agubert, Beck Ridge, and Quality. Again, a truly international group of names in this final four. What a great shot on your screen right now of our final four contestants.
Draw to the end of our heifer show here today. I guess this is a chance I get to say a few words before I wrap the red and white national show up for the year. I'm not going to revel you with stories of days of old like a Bob Morrell or a Mike Deaver might, but I'd like to say a few thank yous at this time. First, I'd like to thank Holstein Canada. I'd like to thank the show committee and all the people that have put countless hours into putting this show on. I know the time and the money it takes to put these events on is staggering, and I applaud them for doing that. As a person who... As a person who works with show cattle, we all realize that it's countless hours, and it's a very small window that these cows have both to be in their prime to show and to be in their prime for marketability, which is equally as important. And to go 2 years without a national show would have been a tragedy, to be honest with y'all. And I'm glad that Holstein Canada took the initiative to put on this show down here in St. Hyacinth. Very necessary for our breed and all involved in it. Next, I'd like to thank the exhibitors for bringing the quality cattle out here they have the last couple days. We all know in our dairy industry these days, the margins are getting tighter and tighter. Our costs seem to go up. Our milk price doesn't seem to climb quite as quickly as we'd like, and that tightens our margins down, and it makes it easy to say, you know, I really don't need to go through the expense to take these cows to the show or the time to wash and lead this cow, but as is proof here, the last couple days, these people still are. They still put the time in. They still have the passion for these animals. And I applaud the exhibitors for the cattle they brought out and the way they presented them. They definitely deserve a big round of applause. I'd also like to thank my ringmen, Murray and Bruno. I've never shown or worked under Bruno before, but I appreciate your efforts. Murray, I always appreciated your direction, the way your professionalism at the Royal Ring, and thank you for your help here the last couple days, you and Bruno, and hopefully we can do it again someday. And lastly, I'd like to, I might get like a guy that did Reds in Madison, get a little emotional here, but I'd like to thank my family for their support. The ones sitting in the stands, supporting me, the ones back in the barn looking after my cows so we can show some cows here this afternoon. I'd like to thank my wife, Tia. Without your support, prodding, direction, sometimes just a good kick in the pants, I know I wouldn't be out here today. Love you, babe. Now we're going to go out and we're going to select our champion heifer, our reserve champion, and our honorable mention. I hope you appreciate him as much as I do. We've had a great heifer show, a great cow show, and a huge credit to everybody involved. Thank you.
There you go, the champion, Kozak Warrior Bombshell, Pierre Boulay, R&F. That heifer, they bought her at the Red Deer Show just a month ago, trucked her down here. She looks spectacular, bred by Kozaks. And actually, Caitlin Kozak is here at the show helping Bryce Fisher and R&F. She'll be excited.
Number 37, a champion junior in the middle 37, Kozak Warrior Bombshell Red, owned by a propriety of Pierre Boulay and R&F Livestock Incorporated. With the reserve, number 39, a reserve in the middle 39, Fortel Mirand Loana Red, owned by a propriety of Fortel Austin Incorporated and Femrefa Incorporated. In mention, a red middle 44, honorable mention number 44, Michelet Juicy Apple Crisp Red, owned by Propriété d'Agribert Société Agricole, Vicarage Holsteins, and Quality Holsteins.
I really like this pair of senior calves, and I'm not going to split them up today. They're going to be your champion and your reserve junior champion heifers. Just my kind of heifers, beautiful, balanced, open, hard tops. As we said in class, I just give my junior champion just a slight advantage, a little longer and leaner and cleaner up through that neck. Maybe just hold her pins down a touch nicer and just prefer the set to her rear leg a little bit over our reserve. Taking nothing away from this heifer again. She's my kind of heifer. She's open. She's hard top. She just fits the pattern really, really closely to our senior calf. And just preferring maybe just the way she tracks out at times on her feet and legs. Just a little taller at the point of her shoulder for her age than our summer yearling heifer we make honorable mention. Three out. Heifers, definitely deserving of championship heifers at a national show. Thank you.
Okay, that's it. We'll see you at 11 o'clock. That's in about three quarters of an hour.
Juge Farlinger pour le choix de ces trois champions juniors. Il admire vraiment les deux jeunes seniors qu'il choisit comme réserve, comme championne et comme réserve. Il donne un léger avantage à la jeunesse qui est championne aujourd'hui. C'est une jeunesse qui démontre un petit peu plus de longueur au niveau de son cou. Un léger avantage au niveau de la position de ses membres et de la position de ses issues par rapport à la très belle jeunesse qu'il utilise comme réserve. Et celle-ci emporte sur la jeunesse un an d'été comme mention honorable. Donne un avantage au niveau de son déplacement. Et aussi une jeunesse qui démontre un petit peu plus d'auteur au garrot par rapport à la belle jeunesse qu'il utilise comme mention honorable. Je vous ferai fi de la liste de remerciements que M. Farlinger a fait dans sa présentation. Je pense que les gens ont très bien compris qu'il voulait remercier le comité organisateur, remercier ses proches pour s'occuper des animaux et de son entreprise lorsqu'il est dans un concours. Il a aussi remercié le comité organisateur et Austin Canada d'avoir apporté et mis en place un concours aussi relevé pour l'industrie. C'est très gagnant, donc merci et bonne fin de journée.
So once again, a reminder that there is a genomic conference going on upstairs on the second floor, beginning shortly. Everyone's welcome. And then we will resume here at 11 o'clock sharp with the black and white cow classes. Alors, juste un dernier appel, une conférence de la genomique en haut deuxième étage. Qui débute bientôt et que nous commençons ici à 11h pile avec les classes de vaches noires.
Monday morning, 7 a.m. I'll be sitting at the same red light. Tuesday's more of the same damn thing, working that 9 to 5. If you're an ex-girlfriend, the IRS or my mama looking for me on a Friday night, I ain't hard to find. You know where I'll be. You can find me in a bar on a stool with some Crown and my cold core, nice cold brew. Talking to the girls, buzzing like a neon. You can find me with a drink in my hand in a honky-tonk with the country band. And if I ever go missing, you won't have to look too far. You can find me in a bar. Sunday morning, 11 a.m. I'll be sitting in the last row pew, listening to the word like I ain't hungover. Preacher man knows the truth. If I ain't at work, Baptist church, and there's a family emergency, the doors are all locked and the lights are off, there's only one place I might be. You can find me in a bar on a stool with some Crown and my cold core, nice cold brew. Talking to the girls, buzzing like a neon. You can find me with a drink in my hand in a honky-tonk with the country band. And if I ever go missing, you won't have to look too far. You can find me in a bar. My cold core, nice cold brew. Talking to the girls and buzzing like neon. You can find me with a drink in my hand in a honky-tonk with the country band. And if I ever don't miss it, you won't have to look too far. You can find me in a bar. You can find me in a bar.
Say, my town's smaller than